Okay, so Michael, here's the tree version of what I just said. So remember, I draw squares as chance nodes, and so chance takes a chance, and half the time we end up in a state where where A has a red card, and half the time I end up in a state where A has, or we end up in a state where A has a black card, okay? If A has the black card, then B gets to choose whether to hold or not. So in fact, let me add a little bit of color for you since you wanted some color. This is the place where A gets to make a decision, okay?
Yep.
And then this is the place where B gets to make a decision.
Got it.
Okay? So A is going to be either in a red state or a black state. Only A knows this. B does not know this, does not know which state he is in. And so let's say A is in a black state. Well, A can only hold in that case, in part because it makes no sense to resign. And then B gets to decide whether to resign, and therefore A gets 10 cents, or to C, in which case A gets 30 cents. By contrast, when we're in the red state, A can either hold or resign. If A resigns, he loses 20 cents. If A holds, then B gets to decide whether to resign, and in which case A gets 10 cents, or to C the card, in which case A loses 40 cents, and B, of course, gains 40 cents. So this is just a tree version of what I just wrote. Does that make sense?
Okay. Yeah, I can see how this kind of captures the flow of information, but I feel like there might be a missing constraint to it.
So I don't know there's actually a constraint missing, but let me just point out something. And that is that B has no idea which of these two states he's in. Hence, hidden information. And because B doesn't know which state he's in, he doesn't know whether to resign or to see. In particular, if B knew that he was in this leftmost state, then he would always say C. If B knew he was in the rightmost state, then he would always resign. But he doesn't know which one, so it's not entirely clear what to do.
Neat. Where did you get this game? This game is awesome.
I got this game like I got all of the examples that we're using today from Andrew Moore.
He's clever.
He is clever, and I have shamelessly stolen all of his examples and materials for this. But he said it was okay by putting up slides in the world and saying, feel free to steal all of this stuff.
Do you want to write his name so that people can credit him?
Yeah, I'm going to write it at the very end when we talk about what we've learned.
Awesome.
Okay. So here's a question for you, Michael. We know that I wrote down a bunch of words which describe the game, and then I made it a tree because I could do that, and it makes it nice and easy to see what's going on. But now we know that, at least based on everything else we've done, we want to make a little matrix. And so we want to figure out what the value is for different strategies for A and B. So I'm going to assert, and I think it's pretty easy to see, I hope, that A basically has only two strategies. Either A is the type of person who resigns when a card is red, or A is the type of person who holds when a card is red.
Interesting. Agreed? Okay. Yeah. Right. So it really is a conditional policy, right? So it's basically, if red, hold or resign, if black, hold or resign. But your point is that black isn't really a choice, red is a choice, and there's only two choices. Okay, I can see that as the two strategies, sure.
Right. And of course, this does say, this does kind of say when you're in the black case, you know you're going to hold, so you know what's going to happen. Ultimately, B can either be the kind of person who resigns whenever A holds, or chooses to C whenever A holds. Right?
I see. So like in the previous trees, B would have four different strategies, resign or C in the left state, resign or C in the right state. Here there's this kind of extra connection, this sort of quantum entanglement between these two states that makes them have to be the same. So there really is just those two choices.
That's exactly right. Although I probably wouldn't have used the phrase quantum entanglement. But yes, there's an entanglement, certainly. Since we can't tell which state we're in, you're either going to resign or you're going to C, and you just don't know what else to do. Okay, so A's a resigner or a holder, B's a resigner or a seer. So the question is, what numbers go in this matrix? And we're going to figure that out by having a quiz.
I kind of saw that coming.
Mm-hmm. Do you think you can figure this out?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, see? Yeah, I can do that. Okay, cool. So let's go then. Go.